Hello guys, this is Gabitech, and today I will present you a very interesting video. This time we're not gonna speak about product, but this time we will speak how you can start YouTube with your $200 phone. For this purpose, I will use Redmi Note 9S, my phone that I did a review about. You can check the review, I'll put link into the description. A Redmi Note 9S is the king in the budget sector right now. It's a very good phone. It has amazing camera capabilities. One of these capabilities is 4K 30 frames footage that I'm filming right now. Right now, this video is filmed with Redmi Note 9S 4K 30 frames. Redmi Note 9S has amazing camera. The main one is 48 megapixel and it has two more, macro camera 5 megapixel and wide angle camera 8 megapixel. It's amazing phone and it costs only $200. You can even find it for less, I'm not sure. But it's a phone. And now I'm showing you that you can do YouTube with your cheap phone and you don't need super expensive camera gear for everything and you still have very nice quality footage. On this video, I can present you my main gear that I normally do my videos with. This is Sony Alpha 6000. It's my first camera. I started YouTube with this camera. This camera is with 24.3 megapixel. It can film video in 1080p, 60 frames maximum. It has different modes and a lot to play with in the main menu. You have aperture priority and so on, so on. Amazing qualities. The camera is good itself. It's a little bit outdated, as I said, but itself is good. There are a couple of problems that I will mention right now. One of them is overheating after 25 minutes. That's the one that I hate most, because I film my video and if it's more than 25 minutes, I'm like, oh, it just turns off out of nowhere and it stops. Everything stops. You need to wait to cool down and then you can continue. This annoys me very much. And that's why I said to myself, why? Just why? And I asked the guy from a camera guy who is professional, why this happens. He said it's not because the camera is mirrorless. A lot of people thinking of mirrorless cameras have overheating problem. It's just the body. The construction of this camera is with very small body, very tiny, very compact. Everything is close to each other and it overheats very fast. One of the main problems, because we filmed a video with him in Bulgarian that I'll try to put closed captions on about cameras and some interesting stuff. We filmed it with Nikon Z6 on 4K 24 frames. It didn't overheat after 1 hour. It was in still very good condition. So it depends of the construction of the body, everything, basically everything about the camera, how it has been projected. Is everything okay inside? Another thing about this camera, the stabilization is not amazing. It has optical steady shot stabilization in the lens, but nothing more than that. This is the kit lens. It comes with the kit lens and the price is around $700 maybe right now. It's just perfectly fine beginner's camera. And one more thing, there is no audio jack. It has only this hot shoe place to put microphone. That hachu sounds like apchihi, apchu, to me like I'm sneezing. But okay, here you can place microphone. The microphone is not amazing quality, that's why I haven't bought it yet. It's just a regular, okay quality microphone. I'm thinking to buy it because I want to go outside. I feel sometimes stuck with this Rode NT on the table in front of me. But it's still okay camera. What can I say bad about it? It's normal. It's normal and it's like, I am very grateful. I even start with something like this that is still expensive. While right now I'm showing you that you can start with your $200 phone without any problems, because phones right now are getting very, very high in every possible way. That they're trying to beat up the normal cameras. Let's see if they're gonna do it. Right now I'm having a drama inside of myself. What should be my main camera, because obviously I need to replace this. And I was thinking R5 when it came out. I was like, wow, R5, so beautiful, everybody's speaking about it, everybody's milking R5. Watched 1,000 videos about it already. And first it was wow, then I heard it's overheating. I said, oh no, not overheating again, no. Then R6, I was thinking, oh, but the megapixels are very low. I'm so brainless because they said to me for a video, my dear sweet little girl, you don't need megapixel, high megapixel, you just need regular megapixel. The megapixels are not important in a video shot. Because a lot of people are thinking, oh, high megapixel, yeah, top-notch quality. It's not like this. It's not like this, unfortunately, in video making, in video filming. It's not like this. And then I looked at R6. It was, the megapixels are less, 20.3 or 21, not sure exactly. But low light capabilities, top-notch, 4K, can film in perfect quality. There were even a lot of comparison videos between R5 and R6, and R6 was sometimes beating R5 over the quality in 4K. You need to put R5 basically on 4K, high quality, maximum quality. They have 10 different modes there, but Canon cameras are amazing. I don't say anything about them. That's why I'm thinking to go R6. But 2 weeks ago or 1 week ago, Sony A7S III came out, and the whole camera was like, wow, Sony just took out their camera. We waited so long and everybody got so excited. And I was like, oh, wow, really? This camera, it looks very nice. Then I read 12 megapixels and I was like, oh, but isn't it that? Okay, I know it doesn't matter, but isn't it a little bit too little? And then I looked some amazing time-lapse footages and everything with this camera. And I was like, okay. And then I heard one more thing. It never overheats. And I was like, okay, we have a win-win here. It doesn't overheat. Then I saw the price and I was like, anyway. And now, since I was in the beginning, I was like, R5. No, but afterwards I went to the camera shop and I filmed a video with the guy who said to me, hey, you know, there is Panasonic Lumix S1, S1H and S1R. They're very good cameras. Why don't you look at them? Then I saw S1H and I was like, S1H. Very good camera, everything top notch, and it has fan inside. Fan means no overheating. I was like, yeah, fam, there is fan. Yes, it was very cool. And I was thinking, okay. Then I watched some videos again. This YouTube makes my life so complicated. Somebody said, oh, the autofocus is very bad. And in YouTube, autofocus is very important. Sadly, you need to have the best autofocus. In S1H, unfortunately, it's not like that. Also, the optical stabilization wasn't good. Bad stabilization, not the best autofocus. And I was like, no. It won't be S1H. And basically, from the past 2 weeks, I was having R5, S1H. Now, like between R6 and A7 S3. And I'm thinking A7 S3 because it doesn't overheat and the Sony lenses are in better price compared to Canon lenses. Yes. And let's not speak that much about camera right now. If you want to continue having sweet camera talks with me, wait for the next videos. Maybe I will know better and I will tell you more stuff. My other camera is Canon EOS 700D. You'll be like, ha 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 ha. Yeah, when I went to the camera store, I said, this is my gear, and they were like, what's this, my dear sweet little girl? And they just took out Nikon Z6 and they said, go away, you little annoying girl with your small gear, you're just a little buck dink. They killed me. Anyway, I filmed with Z6 and I was like, wow, so crisp, so beautiful, so nice to be. I got so amazed and I said, I shouldn't film with my cameras anymore. I feel ashamed. Anyway, having two cameras for a beginner YouTuber like me is still amazing event. And I'm super grateful, so don't take me wrong. I'm grateful for everything I have, but I really want right now R6 or A7 S3. Which one to choose, guys? Give me opinion in the comment section.
Or just have both.
Or just have both if you're cash out, but I'm not, unfortunately. Okay, this video, as I said for the last time, is filmed with Redmi Note 9S, and my gear for this video is Redmi Note 9S and my Huawei selfie stick with tripod. So guys, do you see? You can go from this to this and the selfie stick. Where is the selfie stick box? Here. You can go from this and Canon 700D to this, and probably there won't be much difference in YouTube. We'll check that later. Thank you very much for watching this video. Now I'm gonna try the phone's capabilities in low light or in some next videos. And in the next video, I'll show you the most hyped games on Redmi Note 9S and its octa-core super strong processor Qualcomm Snapdragon 720G. So be aware of it. Like this video, subscribe to my channel, and don't get desperate. You can film YouTube with $200 phone and just a selfie stick, which is like $15.